Cenderawasih Bay is well known for its whale sharks, but it also has some of the best dive spots in the whole world. There are beautiful soft corals all over. As well as large plate corals and large hills of lettuce corals, amongst others. The many large paddle sponges, as well as other corals, are all in a pristine condition, probably due to the remoteness and natural protection of the bay. All along the drop-offs, in a water temperature of 29 degrees centigrade, are many kinds of whip corals, sponges and giant sea fans. Most of the time we had a visibility in excess of 30 meters. There is a seemingly endless variety of sea fans, as well as hard and soft corals. Drifting around with a camera is so frustrating, it's almost like being a kid in a candy store. There are too many beautiful things, you just can't photograph everything. The whole place is so photogenic. The World War II wrecks at Manokwari are considered to be one of the best wreck diving sites in the world. Gliding amongst the wrecks in fairly shallow water, you should soon become enveloped in one of the large schools of fish, one after another. And this is all happening in what could be a garden nursery. You are constantly enveloped by large schools of sweet-lipped emperors and yellowtail snappers. A large school of yellow-blue fusiliers, they're always in a hurry, come sweeping by. A waterfall of sweepers cascading into the hidden caverns. The synchronous movement of small fish mimicking the ever-changing shape of clouds is like poetry in motion. They are commonly found under the jetties. small schools of overactive scavenging juvenile catfish brushing over the surface beneath one of the jetties. A school of barracuda gliding past. There are so many different types of anemone all around every dive site. The nimble Venus anemone shrimps or glass shrimp that float around between and over anemone tentacles can grow up to a maximum size of about 3 centimeters. They are perfectly formed, transparent, blue-tinged creatures. It's difficult not to sit and just watch them for hours on end. Anemone fish are always fascinating to watch. This pink anemone fish is constantly darting in and out between the anemone tentacles. Two very shy domino damsels make their brief appearance in the background. A two-bar anemone fish is also briefly inspecting life outside the anemone. Another clown anemone fish enters and exits the scene briefly. It can also be a common clownfish, or better known as Nemo, in the Walt Disney film Finding Nemo. Never a dull moment in watching the bizarre swimming style of the razorfish. Colorful mantis shrimp has one of the most elaborate visual systems ever discovered. This one looks like a Peneus monodon or a giant tiger prawn. The banded coral shrimp is also known as the boxing shrimp due to this otherwise peaceful shrimp's aggressive behavior towards other banded shrimps. It can move freely between obstacles without its long antennae touching anything. The tiny anemone shrimps almost look artificial with their white spotted tails and transparent glass-like bodies. If it wasn't for the few colored spots on their bodies, they would have been completely invisible. The sexy anemone shrimps are everywhere. The arrow crab is about 2 centimeters in size and very well camouflaged. It walks along the bottom and looks just like a praying mantis. This hermit crab was inquisitive and came over to have a look at what I was doing. When this anemone hermit crab outgrows its shell, the old shell will be discarded and all the anemone on the old shell will also be transferred onto the new shell. The tiny hermit crab grows up to 0.5 millimeters in size. This one was feasting on even smaller krill that were attracted by my strobe lights. This white-spotted, left-handed hermit crab almost seems too big for its shell house. The tiny, extremely busy porcelain crabs are small, usually with a body width of less than 15 millimeters. Not a fraction of a second goes by that they aren't busy doing something.